Presley on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
If you do well in this next game, you will earn the right to see your loved one. If you are not successful, you will not see your loved one.
I'm gonna say the guy in the blue shirt.
No.
Sorry?
Maybe I suckered myself into a coalition with a mole.
I am not going to jump.
Yeah, I think Dorothy will jump.
Dorothy was the only one who didn't get to see her mom. Katie.
A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and is sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the mole. Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the mole.
The fact that I'm here is a victory in itself. The fact that I have such limited knowledge of the mole, there's such little direction as to the identity of the mole, is horrible.
I don't know, Al and Bill seem kind of chummy, so I think they got something going on. I'm wondering if he's sharing information I gave him with Bill. Can't trust anybody, man. I guess it's no honor amongst thieves.
I like the game the way it was. And what we're going into is going to pit each other against one another.
On the 28th day of their journey, the six remaining players gather for breakfast and discover a clue. Four more losers. Which will you be? I'm counting down. Dwindling numbers are key.
I think it's actually detrimental to try and figure out what the clue means before you start a game, because you get something in mind and you may be totally off track. You get in a game and it doesn't occur to you right away.
Maybe it means that we're going to have to use numbers, sort of a combination. Maybe the numbers are of the people that left, maybe their journal numbers.
I did everything in the world I could with that clue and came up with nothing but the words dwindling numbers.
Because you were the last player up for the breakfast table this morning, you get to play your own secret game today. If you succeed, you will neutralize another player. If, however, you fail, you will be the one neutralized. As you know, a neutralized player is not eligible for an exemption in this round of play. To neutralize another player, you have to plant this green thumbprint sticker in some player's journal.
Any place in the journal?
Any place in the journal. If you succeed in planting the sticker in the journal, that player will be neutralized. If you fail, you will be neutralized.
That's for this round?
That's correct.
Okay.
You're not allowed to reveal the game to anyone. It has to remain secret. Even when it is revealed tonight that the player has been neutralized, they will not know who neutralized them.
Okay.
All right, good luck.
Makes you uncomfortable. You got to go after one of your fellow players, but on the other hand, that's still part of the game. Ultimately, for me to win, I've got to neutralize every one of them. Well, I'm here to tell you that if somebody's going to get an exemption, I'd rather it be me than them.
Hello? So, time for some games. Now, I know this first game is going to be difficult, but I need only two players who like to drink wine. Heather, now, if you guys just go down the road, I'll meet you shortly. Sadly, there's no wine in your game. In order to win the game and earn $20,000 for the pot, you have to get my car, this beautiful old Citroen, inside that greenhouse.
Oh my God.
You have 2.5 hours to do this. The greenhouse has sliding doors. One of the doors is locked. You're not allowed to damage the doors, the building. All the tools you'll need to disassemble and reassemble the car are right here. Now, in 2.5 hours, I'll return, and the car has to be inside the greenhouse and it has to be able to start. You're not allowed to test it. I'm the only one who can actually try to start the car. The game begins now.
I think we should just disassemble as much as we can and try to tilt it on its side and get it in.
I think if we're going to disassemble it, we need to lay everything out.
Inside the way, yeah.
We definitely want to stay away from as much mechanical components as we can.
Before we start, let's have a glass of wine, shall we?
Yeah.
Have a seat.
Grazie.
This is from the Fattoria d'Otesso, which is actually these vineyards right here. So, yes. Cheers. This game is worth $10,000. You have 90 minutes to fill up 5 bottles of wine with the juice that you produce from your own 2 feet.
Here, those are the size 14s. Yeah, they really come in handy. They're like grape crushing machines.
You shouldn't be allowed to play this game because you have the unnatural advantage of size 14 feet.
Yeah, I can't even get European footwear.
Only one of you can stomp the grapes at a time, working in 15-minute shifts.
This is the weirdest thing. See, Bill would have been good at this.
The tire's gonna have to come off for sure.
So I think if we just get rid of the frame and then tilt it on its side and get it through.
Yeah.
Then we don't have to even mess with, just like take apart the shell
right.
If you can tilt it upright and get it through the door.
Exactly.
Yeah, I don't know how to use any of this equipment, so although I'm not mechanically inclined, I thought it would be fun to take something apart and put it back together again.
Okay, there's the back door.
In the back of my mind, I felt like the car wasn't the game. I felt like the greenhouse was the game because that's just the way the mole is.
Although the players are suspicious about the greenhouse, they decide to continue with their original plan.
What's the time?
We got 55 minutes gone. An hour and 35 minutes to go. There we go.
Ta-da!
It's 100 centimeters. So we're not going to be able to go straight in there like this. So I think we're going to have to take the tires off to get in there. It's 100 centimeters wide again.
All right.
We're going to have to turn it outside anyway, so. Turned it outside, looked at the bottom, realized the car could not be split in two. There was no effective way to do that. Well, guys, we're going to have to look at this engine again. I hate to say it.
That's a four-hour job.
You know they've done it in that time. It's just a matter of can we do it.
There's no way.
We're going ahead with the wine without you.
I got some slop down here. Yeah, oh.
Yeah.
High step now. Running in, look.
Want me to give a test to the screening method here?
Maybe since you have the bigger feet, you should spend your time stomping and I can spend all my time squeezing.
What are you trying to say, Anna?
I'm trying to come up with some sort of strategy.
Hey, Bigfoot, I have an idea.
You're almost there. Good job, Al.
I love it. If we get to drink that for like another 20 grand,
gross.
We're going down 20 grand.
It smells like your feet, Al.
I'm sure it does.
My feet are clean enough to serve the wine that we stopped. I don't have any problem. I shower all the time.
Oh, yeah. Good job. Ew. I really didn't stomp that much. Al pretty much took care of the stomping, and I did most of the squeezing or pouring the juice into the wine bottles.
You got a gift.
Beautiful.
All right, three more.
We may have another job.
I think we can do it.
We may have another job here.
Yeah. Al was slamming those glasses of wine.
Should we move on to Frizzante? Sure, we'll give that a shot. Cheers. Did I get juice in my ass? Did I sit in it?
A little bit.
I knew it, I knew it.
Ooh. Hey, man.
I was trying to be conservative because I just knew something was going to happen.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
You have to convince the other four players to consume one bottle of your gnarly toad jam wine.
Oh, yeah. Then I'll make a lot of new friends.
Did this young man brutally murder his wife, or is he taking the fall for the woman he really loves? Why settle for another Law & Order repeat when you can watch State B Wednesday?
I'm just trying to see if we can get that engine out. If we can get the engine out, we could actually pick it up.
With an hour and 15 minutes left, and faced with the daunting task of removing the engine, the players go back to searching the greenhouse when Darwin makes a significant discovery.
Combination, people. He said the door's locked. I don't know. So if we can figure out the combination, we can open the door and slide this sucker right in. I knew it was the greenhouse.
I can't believe that we were so asinine as to not take into consideration the clue earlier on in the day.
So, hey, how many? Get your books out.
What number combination?
Four. There are four numbers.
What's on the license plate?
5601. Try 1065.
Here, descending. Try 9876.
Darwin, don't you agree that the answer is in the lock?
Yeah. Okay. This is what we have to do.
Okay. So, do you want to start putting same time, start putting things back on?
Yeah.
So all we have to do is push it in.
Because he said we can't move it on its side. We're not going to be able to take the engine out. We can't split it in half.
Let's start putting
it back together.
Dwindling numbers, guys. What does that mean? Four more losers. We have four numbers.
Four numbers, four losers. Losers numbers. We gotta find, maybe from the books.
Let's do from when they were executed. So Katie was six.
Not it, but let's try it.
Try 6, 1, 8.
It's a fine blend of Heather and Al toe jam. It's hard to put your finger on it, really.
Wonderful.
We looked out, Al. I guess there's some sort of hidden task here, I'm sure.
Remarkable. So you have one more bottle remaining?
Al, you're going to be able to finish this next time. I almost have this one done.
You guys have only been working for about 30 minutes.
Excellent.
So one bottle left to go.
Yeah!
$10,000, very nice.
Really?
All right!
Good job! That was really way too easy. What's going on? No, I feel like it has to be something easier. I already tried 6543. My first thought was trying 000 before realizing, oh, there's never zero players in the game. I knew it had to be something to do with how many players were currently in the game and how many would be left at the end. And that's really what prompted me to reverse the numbers and try 3456.
I got it, guys.
You got it?
What was it?
3456.
3456?
Yeah.
What's our time?
We have like 45 minutes.
3456.
It makes sense. There's gonna be three people left at the end. There's six of us now.
Dwindling numbers.
But that's a ascending number.
Doesn't really make any sense.
I was looking across at the speedometer and odometer, and then I started laughing. And I told everybody, look at the odometer.
The
I can't believe it.
Oh, nice.
With only 35 minutes remaining, Bill still must complete his secret game. If he places a sticker in a player's journal, the player will be neutralized and will be ineligible for an exemption. If Bill doesn't succeed, he'll be the one neutralized. A Over the course of an hour, Al has consumed 7 glasses of wine and Heather 4. This next game will test their judgment and coordination.
Al, you look like kind of a betting man. I got a little wager for you. You have to fill the glasses with wine, put one glass on top, pick up the tray. You can use 2 hands to pick up the tray, but then you have to carry the tray using 1 hand all the way down to that table and place this tray on the table without spilling a drop. Now, I'll give you $5,000 if, however, you spill a drop, glasses fall, anything happens, it will cost you $5,000.
Oh, man.
So wait, let me get this straight. For each person, it's $5,000?
That's correct.
I think we should do it. It's 10 grand.
It's only 10 grand.
Yeah.
So at worst, we come away at zero.
Heather and I, we both came to the conclusion that 10 grand is going to make or break the pot.
Oh.
Does that mean I'm out?
The game was, you're not allowed to spill a drop.
So I'm out already?
Yeah.
It's a bottle, man. I've never poured a glass of wine in my life sober without getting a drip off the lip. This thing isn't contoured for pouring.
As someone who was once a waiter, I could certainly show you how to pour it without spilling.
Oh, okay, Mr. Professional, please show me.
I was so glad that he couldn't pour it in there because we couldn't. And he was trying like heck.
I've been drinking with you.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, Al. You seem a little unruly to me.
Oh, hey, listen, man.
I'm so nervous.
Heather?
Can I win?
Win.
Oh, we're done! We are done!
We didn't realize that the pouring was going to count. After the fact, I realized it was one of those nearly impossible things to do.
You made $10,000 pretty easily, then quickly lost $10,000. You haven't earned anything for the day. I'm going to give you one more chance to earn some money for the pot. Tonight at dinner, you have to convince the other 4 players to consume 1 bottle of your gnarly toad jam wine. But you can't tell them that it will earn $10,000. And I probably wouldn't recommend you telling them you made it with your stinking feet.
Oh, yeah. Then I'll make a lot of new friends. Did you drink that?
Oh, my God.
Let's go ahead and move it in.
Yeah, that's what I think we should do.
And we're done except for just final tightening.
Only 15 minutes remain, and the players still have several parts to reassemble. But in order to win the $20,000, the car must also start. While Darwin, Bribs, and Dorothy are busy making final adjustments to the car, Bill moves to neutralize one of his fellow players.
I saw no choice but to neutralize somebody and keep my mouth shut. And so I did that. I mean, I couldn't see any way out of that. That was part of the game.
The car is inside. Very impressive. Wow, just in the nick of time, too.
It's tough.
You got some grease on you.
Well, when you split a car into quarters and then you reassemble it, you get grease on it. That's the way to do it.
All right, let's see if it works. Did it?
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
Heather and I would be really appreciative if the 4 of you were to consume this bottle.
The players were successful in getting the car into the greenhouse, but to win the $20,000, the car must start.
Congratulations, you earned $20,000 for the pot. I know you disassembled the car outside first, and before you realized the combination on the lock actually could have meant something. You might be interested, I don't know if you picked up on the letters on the license plate, like spell out mole. So the only 2 places there are numbers on the vehicle, the license plate and the odometer.
The clue said dwindling numbers are key. The numbers on the odometer are dwindling, and once reversed, give the correct combination.
You got the car inside, it started, you earned $20,000. Congratulations, you won the game.
As the players celebrate, Al and Heather discuss how to convince the others to drink a bottle of their freshly stomped wine.
We're going to say our game for $10,000 was to make 5 bottles of wine, which we successfully did.
In 90 minutes.
In 90 minutes. Then we had the opportunity to wager the $10,000 we won.
Could have doubled our money.
We could have doubled our money or lost it all, and we were unsuccessful.
We were unsuccessful in doing that, so
yes.
We were back down to zero.
We were back down to zero. Now, we would really
However,
like for you...
However, as a favor to us, we would really appreciate it if our efforts did not go unrewarded and you guys shared in our winemaking.
If Heather and Al can convince the other players to drink a bottle of their freshly stomped wine, they'll earn $10,000 for the pot. But to win, they cannot reveal that money is involved.
If they drink this, it's going to be unbelievable.
You have to keep a straight face.
Oh, I can keep a straight face.
Look, I can't. No, I can't.
I was feeling marvelous. I had a lot of wine, so I was happy, and so was Heather. And I knew what my game plan was, so I was like, all right, we could do this. No problem.
Why don't we start by you guys telling us about your day?
Okay. Our game was to make 5 bottles of wine in 90 minutes to earn $10,000, which we did. And we relaxed, and then came the other half. We were offered the opportunity to gamble the $10,000. We lost the money that we had earned.
How much wine did you guys drink before you did this?
About 6 or 7 glasses. She had about 4 glasses.
And you thought you guys would be able to carry this thing down?
It just seemed like we were cool.
He's still drunk.
So maybe their judgment was clouded. You know, taking the bet, they were arguing that it simply wasn't possible. But then again, they were basically drunks.
We brought some of the wine that we made. And let me just say this. Heather and I would be really, really appreciative if the four of you were to consume this bottle before dinner ends. And we would be really appreciative.
But I figured if I elongated the we, like the group we, and they got it, that they would know that it wasn't just about us.
Appreciative as an exemption appreciative or appreciative as in...
No, I'm not drinking wine.
Dorothy's a bright girl. You know, she's extremely bright. She's got to know that there's no alcohol in there. She's got to know it.
$10,000 they lost. They could have won 20. So is it going to be a $20,000 game? Is it going to be
an exemption game?
A $10,000 game? Is it worth the risk? You know, being a little loopy, he wanted to stress how important it was that everybody taste it and we finished the bottle. So I'm trying to think about what I want to do. There are two possibilities right now. If we taste the wine, then we taste the wine. But if you taste the wine, then we can all finish the wine. And that's a different story.
Well, it could be two different scenarios.
It could be 5 different scenarios.
We would be happy.
Now, Brib says there's 5 or 6 different possibilities. I say there's really 2. Either we're going to drink that bottle of wine, which gives them an exemption, or we're going to drink that bottle of wine, which gives all of us money.
We made it. We drank it.
I mean, it's
enjoy
just
it,
like fruit juice.
And we'll all be happy.
That's all I'm saying.
It's not bad, right? It's not bad.
Did you squash this with your feet?
We are not allowed to discuss the methods in which we made this wine.
It tastes like fruit juice.
I really do not like the taste of wine. It just makes me feel nauseated. You know, my whole face gets flushed.
You've tried some. You've tried some. I haven't. You haven't. If I'm going to drink some, you definitely have to drink some.
What do I have to do?
And you don't have to do anything.
Okay.
But if you don't drink the wine, there may be an exemption, which is why I'd rather we all drink the wine.
Well, all right, I'll leave it up to Darwin.
Let's drink it.
Now, we would be really appreciative if you guys would honor us by finishing this bottle.
Can we do it?
I'm going to do it.
Bill?
Yeah.
No. We can drink hers, though.
Yeah,
we must finish the bottle.
The level of trust has decreased significantly. And I know Dorothy certainly doesn't trust anybody because she didn't even want to taste the wine.
Let's cheers.
Let's do it.
I don't necessarily find it suspicious that Dorothy doesn't drink. I find it pretty smart on her part. And I found that one beer will cut down my capacity to play the game significantly.
Cheers.
Because you guys had finished a bottle of wine,
We added our $10,000 right back.
Yeah. Do you want to tell them how you made that wine?
Actually, but it was with our feet.
Yeah, we squashed the grapes.
Yummy. Al and his disgusting feet stomping that wine just flashed through my head. It tasted fine. Got a hair in my tooth, though.
Al and Heather's wine, it didn't really taste like wine. It tasted kind of like fruit juice. But it wasn't bad. It didn't taste like feet.
If yeah. I could see all your journals, please.
Come on. Come on.
Heather and Ribs are really close to Anderson, and as he's starting to flip through it, my first thought is, oh great, I don't want anyone else to see what I've written in there.
That's a mole print.
Whose journal is number 15? This means that you've been neutralized in this round of play. Any exemption that is offered in this round, you will not be eligible for. You've been neutralized by one of your fellow players.
Oh, mackerel. And I was like, whoa, how the heck did that happen, man? I mean, because journals are sacred.
You guys earned did very well today. Dorothy, sorry about the neutralizer. $30,000 was earned, so the pot now stands at $376,000. So you're racking up the money. Good job. So have a good night.
Such an idiot. I will never leave my journal unattended again. Serves me right.
Time for a game. Will you please follow me?
Are you serious?
Hey, Darwin. Sorry to wait, but it's time for a game.
I was a little surprised when Anderson came in. He usually doesn't wear a suit when he sneaks into my room. He comes in his pajamas, just the bottoms usually.
It's time for a game.
I know it, man.
King Al?
Yeah.
Time for a game.
Oh, good.
I open my eyes and I look up and there's Anderson.
Time for a game. Please get up.
No, it isn't. It's time for sleep. Do you see me in bed?
Hey, Dorothy. It's time for a game.
Oh, what?
So, please follow me. Sort of a come as you are game.
Hello, this is excellent.
You all remain standing. We thought we'd have one last game for you all tonight. Now, this game may not be the most intellectually challenging, but it is time-consuming. In fact, it may consume most of the time you had to sleep tonight. You have to keep this ball moving until 6 a.m. If you do that, you earn $30,000 for the pot. Now the trick is in the rotation system. The ball must be continuously moving. You have to hit it each once per rotation and in the same order each time. For instance, if you're all playing, you might go in the order you're in now. Dorothy would have to hit it first, then Bribs, then Darwin, then Al, then Heather, then Bill. You'd have to continue hitting it in that same order all night long. If you are hit by the ball, or you hit the ball out of order, you have forfeited the game and the game ends. It's quite simple. Keep the ball in motion until 6 a.m. You earn $30,000 for the pot. Please pick an order.
We should probably do it now. Please pick an order. So at least just so we know what the order is, it's an easy order to remember.
I feel that an exemption will be offered in this game because Dorothy was neutralized for a reason. And because we had two games earlier, this, you know, logically would be the game for the exemption.
I'll start the ball off.
Thanks. I'm going first, yeah.
Scares
what are you
kid.
Doing?
Getting the thing moving.
There's got to be something where we can actually keep it moving without having to hit it every time. I feel very frustrated because it's one of those impossible games. And the whole time I'm thinking there's got to be a catch here. There's something very simple about it.
Try to get it in a real good circle. It should be a lot easier.
Yeah, you stink.
Heather kept hitting the ball, and it was like back and forth. They were trying to get in a circle, so I had to keep getting up. And I was like, geez, Heather, can you hit the ball near me? I mean, I'm tired of getting up.
I can't hit it from over here. That's
right. Don't get frustrated. It's just a game.
The trick is not to watch the damn thing unless it's your turn.
Yeah.
awake now.
Do not stop hitting the ball. Please continue hitting the ball. I'd like to know who here is the most tired.
I'm pretty tired, I'll tell you that.
Does anybody want to be the most tired, other than Al?
So, Al, you're the most tired?
Apparently so.
All right. Al, I'm excusing you from the rest of the game. You can go back to sleep. Everyone else, please just eliminate Al from your order.
Good luck, kids.
Yeah, sleep well, Al.
Oh, don't worry. I'm going to win at that game. Good luck, kids. I've worked very hard to earn as much money as I could, but you're going to give me 10 glasses of wine and then send me to bed and then wake me up in 2 hours and ask me to be happy about participation? I don't care how much money it's worth. I was tired.
He's going to need an offer and exemption?
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
I have an offer to make to you. You can earn an exemption for yourself if you forfeit this game right now by hitting the ball out of turn. How's it going?
It's going.
Good.
So I need to know who's the most tired. You're the most tired?
Did you hit it?
Yes, yeah, she did.
All right, Heather, you're excused from the game. You can go back to bed. Everyone else continue. Just take Heather out of the rotation.
This is definitely going to get easier with less people.
We all knew there was an exemption looming someplace. We were just waiting for the opportunity to come up.
I am amazed how easy it is to lose track of who hit it. Sit here and suddenly in a fugue and wonder who the hell hit it last.
I think this game is an easy one to sabotage and pass it off as an honest mistake.
I wish those yellow stripes weren't on it. It made me sick.
You make me sick.
I figured that the game would be whoever could outlast everyone else, making an exemption or something like that. So there's no way they're getting me out of there.
I need to know who's the most tired.
Bill.
Bill, you're the most tired?
Yeah, I guess.
I have an offer to make to you, Bill. You can earn an exemption for yourself if you forfeit this game right now by hitting the ball out of turn. You, of course, will be depriving the other players of money, but you will be guaranteed to proceed into the next round. If you guys want to, you can talk them out of it, or Bill, you can make your choice at any time.
What do y'all think? Let's go home.
Screw it.
All right.
I don't know if you've ever knocked a tether ball around and around in a circle for 5 hours and have never missed a time, but I never have, nor do I intend to ever try it again if I can avoid that.
Bill, you've earned an exemption for yourself. No money was earned, and you can all go back to sleep.
Colossal waste of time. Can I just once have an exemption, one time?
Before Bill could make his decision about the exemption, I went ahead and kicked the ball out of turn.
Did you do it on purpose?
Yeah.
But he didn't notice.
If they get us for the technicality, then nobody has the exemption.
We'll find out tomorrow.
I can't have it. No one can have it.
Evening, Anderson.
As you know, in last night's game, Bill had the opportunity to earn an exemption if he was willing to effectively end the game, deprive the group of $30,000. After some hesitation, he decided to earn that exemption by hitting the ball, ending the game. After the game, Darwin said that he had seen Bribs hit the ball twice in a row before Bill had the chance to earn his exemption. Last night's game was videotaped by many different cameras. I wanted a chance to review the tapes today, which I've done, and I thought I would show you this. This is a tape that was taken at the time that I offered Bill the exemption. There's Bribs once with his foot and twice. Bribs made the choice to end the game and forfeit the money for the group. I found it interesting, Bribs, because in the Gladiator game, you were given the chance to earn an exemption. And you made a decision based on your moral code. Has the game changed for you, or does your moral code allow you to rob an exemption from another player?
We had all discussed that, you know, if given the exemption, anybody would have taken it that was still there. Knowing that the money was gone and an exemption would have been given,
from a player's standpoint, you don't want exemptions given to another player.
Has the game changed for me? Perhaps.
Do I still think I have morals and ethics and integrity? Yes, I do.
There's actually one other thing I thought I'd point out. I actually noticed something last night during the game, but I wanted to have a chance to look at the tapes before I said anything.
I find this
tape interesting as well. This is actually a tape that was taken much earlier in the game. It was actually taken around the time that Heather decided that she would depart. This tape actually involves Darwin. His name is Darwin. Bribbs hits the ball. It's now Darwin's turn to hit the ball, but he actually encourages Dorothy to hit the ball.
Come on, man. You watched him hit it, and then you just passed it along.
So actually, Darwin ended the game quite early on, around the time Heather's departure.
Then you let us go to bed.
Darwin.
Wait, Darwin, did you...
I know it looks really bad, but I have no idea that I did that. It was just a mind fart. How am I going to convince you any other way?
You're not going to convince me of anything.
The only thing I could say is, if I actually wanted to end the game in that manner, why would I do it so secretly? You know what I mean? Why wouldn't I just end the game?
Maybe you were trying to get Dorothy to end the game, so we'd be questioning her instead of you.
Well, as you know, you're all about to take your quiz about the identity of the mole. Afterwards, you all face execution. Dorothy, you were neutralized in this round of play. We're not eligible for an exemption. No one, however, earned an exemption in this round, so you are all vulnerable tonight. So I want to wish all of you a lot of luck.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
Welcome to the catacombs of Luca. Tonight, you now face your ninth execution as a group.
It is time for the quiz. 10 questions about the mole. The player with the lowest score will be executed and must leave the game immediately. Question number one. What size shoe does the mole wear?
Al's feet are size 14. Extremely large feet, and he's made several comments about them all through the trip.
Number two. As you faced me, was the mole sitting to the left or the right of their loved one at the last execution? Number three. What happened to the mole during the all-night ball game?
I'm not really surprised that Bill hesitated for the brief moment that he did, because he's always talking about how it's important to be honorable. But you know, his honor seemed to fly right out the window 3 seconds later when he stopped the ball.
Number four. Did the mole drive to the interviews today? Number five. What kind of alcohol does the mole prefer to drink? Number six. How many glasses of wine did the mole drink before going to dinner during the grape game?
I was surprised Al wanted to partake in the wine tasting as opposed to doing the assembly line game. He had said to me on several occasions before that he's good with mechanics.
Number seven. At the start of all night ball, in which position was the mole in the rotation? Number eight. Was the mole neutralized yesterday?
I'm not certain who neutralized me, but I suspect Bill. I inspected the sticker. I picked up the edge, and there was a little white hair.
Real curious how that got in there. Dorothy didn't seem to know, but I think she put it in there herself.
Number nine. Did the mole enter the correct combination into the lock during the assembly line game?
Dorothy was the one handling the lock with the combination. I mean, that's twice now that she saved us at the last minute in playing a game and winning the money.
I really never suspected Darwin as far as the mole, except for tonight. We reviewed the videotape of the all-night ball game. I don't know if that was on purpose or not, but he definitely raised some suspicion in my head.
Number 10, who is the mole?
Welcome to the catacombs of Luca. We thought this an appropriate spot to stage tonight's execution. Tonight, you now face your ninth execution as a group. I want to commend you all for making it this far. The game has been very difficult. You've all done very well. The pot now stands at $376,000. You've all just taken the 10-question quiz about the identity of the mole. As you know, the player who gets the most answers wrong on the quiz is the player who will be executed tonight. I'll begin entering your names into the computer. If a green screen appears after your name has been entered, you remain in the game. If, however, a red screen appears after your name has been entered, you are the game's ninth victim. All right, let's begin. Good luck. Bill. Dorothy. Heather. We're now down to three players, Al, Ribs, and Darwin. Al. Ribs. Darwin.
The most difficult part about the game is trying to figure out what's real and what's not real. You know, you feel like you have a gut feeling, and it's hard to trust facts because you never know if anything really is a fact. So you try and go on gut. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. This time, it didn't work for me.
I'm gonna take a bag here.
I'm really surprised to see him go tonight. Darwin is such a fast thinker, very observant. He's a hilarious guy. I'm gonna really miss his very blunt sense of humor that he brought to the group.
Both of you, look at you, sitting there with two exemptions.
Turn around.
Exemption face.
How'd you know that was an A?
Because I'm the mole. Oh my God.
I think the group's gonna be missing his push. He provided a lot of energy with the competitive edge that he had with him.
Darwin was a fierce competitor, but more than that, he was, as much as you can in this game, a friend.
He spent more time talking to Bribs one-on-one than he did with me, so I felt like I was getting played, so I think maybe in the end he got played.
I miss you.
All right. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Darwin.
The ultimate spy game.
Go!
Is down to the final five.
Good luck, girl. Good luck, girl.
And an unexpected alliance.
All right, who do you want to knock out first?
Could change everything.
It's time to play.
Fresh clues and a new episode of The Mole 2 next Tuesday at 9/8 Central, only on ABC.